Okay, so what is a reusable mapping? Once you create a mapping, so this will be used in two angles. One is if you have any mapping created and if you want to use this logic in other mappings, okay, you can use. Generally, the equivalent naming convention for reusable mapping in older version of ODI is yellow mapping. Or generally, that is called interfaces, so yellow interfaces. So this has been renamed to reusable. This can be used in two ways. Okay, first we'll see what is reusable. Say for example, I'm going to develop a mapping. So first I'll tell you what is the best use case for the reusable mapping. So I'm going to create a new reusable mapping. First let me show the problem scenario, then I can. Okay, so this is the source table as usual, and I want to read the data and then I want to apply some analytical functions here. So what analytical, and since we already know these analytical functions, I'm just writing. So generally, why do we write this analytical function? Previously, we know this. In what scenario generally we will write this and then use this analytical function? So to eliminate duplicates, I will generally write this analytical function. So if you practice, you will come to know. Okay? So because this is your bread and butter for you. When you are working in any of the projects or anywhere, these are the very common things. Okay, so now I will write this function, and then what it will give for every employee, if it is repeating 1, 2, 3 times, it will give serial number 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So I want to take only unique records. So what generally in SQL, what we do? This is the actual source table and we have written some derivation, and if I want to read only one unique records for every employee number, in a SQL, what I do generally? Okay, so now if I have written a derivation, serial number will generate 1, 2, 3 numbers for every employee number. If I want to pick up only unique records, what should I do now? Say in the, this is a problem statement. I have written a function and then I want to pick up only unique records. What should I do now in the mapping? So we have to take a component, filter component, and then take the serial number. So this serial number column is there in the expression. So this is what generally, and this I can load to any target table. So now when you see this one, maybe even a couple of people ask how to write analytical functions also. You can go and write analytical functions. Okay, there is no showstopper. If I am just writing analytical function, there is no problem. Say for example, currently I am deleting this filter. I'll come back to filter again. This I am loading to target table. Okay, so employee number, employee name, everything got my, and this serial number I'll link to surrogate key. Okay, because it will generate some number. I have a dummy column, so I linked it. So this surrogate key column, we are not generating the surrogate key. Whatever number is coming, I am just pushing to this column, that's all. Okay, it is not a surrogate key, because just to show that how this works. As usual, I can define a integration type, that is integration strategy, and then I can go to physical. So this is a very straightforward, we are not doing anything. We have the analytical function, I am writing it and then taking and loading to target. Okay, so now you can see we have written an analytical function and it is populating the data. I have taken those numbers and then given into surrogate key. Means it is a one column, and since there are same employee number appearing twice, I see employee number 73691, 73692 and remaining all one time we have. Okay, so this is how you can write analytical function, absolutely fine. If I go and see the log file here, okay, so whatever function we have written, so this function is coming as a column here, and then so now as we just now discussed, if I want to capture only unique records, what is that I am planning to do? I am planning to keep a filter. I'm linking to filter and I'm going to apply a condition here. Since I want only serial number column 1, I want only unique record. So I'm keeping serial number equal to 1, say apply. Then this I'm taking and loading to target. Even if you don't link to serial number also, that should be fine because I am not worried about the column. Since I am already have the column, looking for a unique records, I am loading. Okay, now we'll see what kind of SQL. So the previous activity was writing analytical function and using them in a target. So there is no problem. So now I have written an analytical function. On top of that, I am applying some derivation here. Where on top of analytical function. So I'm running it again. So now you see a failure. Okay. Now what is happening when you apply a derivation on analytical function? This is a technical Oracle database, RDBMS, okay, limitation. So what is happening? You have written a query, you have written an analytical function that we have seen, and we are applying a filter on analytical function. So this is the serial number column actually, and I mentioned serial number equal to 1. So that's why this is nothing but serial number, and it says serial number equal to 1 means this function equal to 1. But from the database point of view, what is the limitation is, you cannot directly use analytical function columns, okay, in any of the further derivations or any other, whether it is a filter condition or whether you are summing up something with something. So in any other way, you cannot. So right now, if I see, even if I execute here, it will get an error saying that window functions are not allowed here. This is that data. Not only here, in all the RDBMS technologies, this is the limitation where I cannot use it. Okay. But how can I make this successful? What is that actual query which will make this as a successful? No, this is the query I have. And how can I make this query successful? Successfully, I want unique numbers and I want this query. So what is the change I need here? Okay. You cannot write analytical functions directly in a single query. You have to make it as a inline view. See, what is this here? How this is your actual query. And for this, we have a serial number column. Okay. This is your actual serial number column. And this I want to use outside, not. So this is, so without where condition, okay, this query will be successful. So the only problem in this, where condition is a problem, okay. So this I am giving as alias, serial number. That alias means column alias because it's a big num values thing. So I just given as a serial number. This is our actual query. And I want to filter only one record. So what is there in the top? So this is called inline query. So I am not writing directly. This is whatever query is there. That output I am treating as a table. Okay. So for this, I'm giving a reference name. Okay, you can give any name. Okay, now what is happening? This query, the complete query output will be considered as a table. not the actual table, whatever output, including your serial number, okay, that output will be considered as a temporary inline table, means inline, we are not storing it permanently. Okay, so now if I say select star from this, this is equivalent to same table. So now, for the entire result, whatever is coming, okay, this entire result you can treat as a table T or A, B, C, you can give any name. Now, since it is another table, now I can go and write serial number equal to 1. So, because this is the alias number, so this is 1. So, this is how analytical functions will be written. So, here, you can, maybe if you want to understand this, you can also call as a subquery, okay, generally that is not the right word, but if you want to easily understand, if you are tough for you to say inline view, at least you can say subqueries, at least remember in that way, okay, or select queries within the query, you can, but actual wording is inline view, because it is not permanent view, because we are not storing. As soon as I query, my query is completed, this T will not be there. This will be completely gone. Okay, as part of the SQL, inline to make some operations, we are doing it. So now, I want to facilitate this kind of feature in ODI right now. Okay, since you are writing any derivation you write, it is going to combine as a single query in ODI. So this is not possible. Okay, so that's why what I am going to do. I'm going to make this, whatever logic is there, whatever I'm planning to build, this logic as a subselect kind of query or inline query. Okay. So, to do this, now we know the problem here. The problem is here. So, that's why what I'm doing, I'm going to create a reusable mapping. What is, maybe in this case, if you want to understand, whatever this part of SQL is there, this SQL, I want to use as a table, or I want to make this query happen, then on top of that, I want to apply something else, and this I want to make it as a subselect. So, this logic I am planning to keep in a reusable mapping. Okay, so this is one of the best use case where you reusable mapping, and apart from this, reusable mapping means any logic which you want to reuse in multiple mappings, you can use it. There are two things. Okay, first I'll show very basic, then I'll show this example. So I'm going to create a new mapping here. Okay, so now where I'm not creating a mapping, I'm creating a reusable mapping, not the original mapping. It is a reusable mapping. Okay, say okay. It is equivalent to Maplet in your Informatica. Okay, so when you create a reusable mapping, in the component section, apart from these components, you will see two extra components, input, signature, and then output. So, this is equivalent to Informatica Maplet input and output transformation. Okay. So, input means consider that, assume that, presume that somebody will give some values. Okay. And then whatever values you want to take, let's say generally, I'll take employee information. So, I'm selecting input signature and saying I'm taking columns, commission. All are numeric only. So input signature means generally when you write a function or a procedure, for this function procedure, what are the input parameters you supposed to give or you are planning to give? That input signature is nothing but your actual thing, what you are going to pass as an input to your reusable mapping, or let's say kind of procedure. So somebody will pass, not here, okay, assume that if somebody passed commission, salary and employee number, so I want to take them and then I want to write some logic. So this is the expression, and in the expression I am writing one more column. So, and writing some derivation. What derivation? I'll write NVL of, sorry? So, I'll take three columns as an input, okay, and somebody will give later, and whatever comes, commission, salary, employee number, and then I'm writing some derivation here to take commission and salary and then sum it up. And this output I want to throw to outside. Okay, and if you want to place here also, you can place, but this I want to throw outside. Okay, so I'm going to take output signature. And this is it. So this is like a, if you have a procedure function, this is like a input parameters, and this is like a output parameter. Okay, so mapping is done. So, but it doesn't have any real source or real target, but we'll give as the input and we'll write some derivation and we'll throwing as output. Okay, so this is a reusable mapping here. So now I'm going to call, I'm going to create a new mapping. So, this is my actual source, okay, I'll have some employee numbers and all that, okay. So, this I want to take and then I want to calculate commission plus salary, whatever I get from here, and then rest all I want to load into target, okay. So, since you already developed a logic in the reusable, in the form of reusable mapping, where if you pass any values, salary, commission, it will sum up NVL and then throw the output. So, rather than developing logic here again, okay, so we already developed the logic, I am going to place over here. So, whenever you place a reusable mapping, okay, this will be showing what are the input parameters you will give and what are the output parameters, okay. So, right now I am going to give employee number as an input and commission as an input, salary as in, if you are planning to give more also you can give, but right now just three have given. So when I run this mapping, this will go to here and internally it has a logic and it will apply that logic, and then this is the output you will get, and this output I am planning to load to this target table. So this is like, there is nothing great here, Okay, from the performance point of view or from any other angle point of view, there is no benefit actually. Rather than you developing the code here, so we already have developed the code and tested. So that's why this code I mean. So what is the advantage right now I'll get is the similar derivation if I want to use in 10 mappings, I don't need to develop this. Okay, and I can just place them. This is called reusability. So advantage is it will minimize the developer efforts. And in case you want to make it, and right now it is salary plus commission. And this I am using in 10 mappings. So now there is a change. I want to make salary minus commission. If you have not done this, and if you have individually developed this in all the mappings, you have to go and change every mapping. But right now, you have developed in one place and then reusing in 10 mappings. If I change in this mapping, then that will be enforced and reflect on all other mappings. So this is the, it is going to minimize the developer efforts. That's all. There is no other gain. Okay. So the only thing is, it is going to minimize the development efforts. Okay. Because that is called reusability. Okay. So now as usual, so I'm going to take the target. Control append fine and physical. And now if you come to physical activity, you can see this is your source and this value will go to signature, input signature. From there it is going to expression. Okay. Within that reusable mapping you have expression. From there it will go to output. And if you have put 20 logics here, all those logics will come. So now it has become a single mapping. Okay. Only thing is from the developer point of view, code is written somewhere place, but when I'm running it, it is a single code only. The only advantage is the reusability is one advantage right now. So, though they are in two different components, but you can see a single query. It is reading, selecting all these columns and commission plus salary, and this is going to load into this target. So, how many input map, how many reusable mappings you may keep here? So, they all will become a single in the runtime. So, you don't need to worry how they will get merged. Okay, that will be taken care by ODI. Okay, so this is fine. Now, what I am going to do? When you are using reusable mappings, there is also an additional benefit. Okay, so what is that benefit I am going to show you now? I am going to create one more reusable mapping. So still I am in reusable mapping. I place directly source. I am not keeping the input. I am placing source directly. And now I am taking the expression component. Previous reusable mapping was using input signature. But right now I directly placed my source. Okay, there is no input required for this. I am directly keeping my input here. Okay, and this I'm going to give as a output and not writing. If I again link to a target, then it will become a mapping only. Okay, and this cannot be used. So this is a reusable mapping and I'm going to place output. So I have not taken any input, means I'm directly taking input and this I'm loading to, I'm throwing to output. So this mapping, this reusable mapping, will not have any input signature. Okay, it will have output signature. What is there? I'm selecting the columns and writing some analytical function, and then now, in this scenario, since your reusable mapping already have a source, no input, and it will throw the output that you can take and then process. So I'm going to create a new mapping now. I'm calling a reusable mapping which has the analytical function. So this is reusable and I'm dragging here. Previous reusable mapping was having both input and output. But this will have only output because inside it already have the source. Now I can take this. Okay, then what I want to apply filter on this serial number column. So this is coming from previously and then apply a filter, then this I want to load to another target. So in this situation, I have written an analytical function in a first reusable mapping. And advantage is I can use that logic in 100 mappings. That is the reusability. And I am calling here and then. So now if I run this, this is equivalent to whatever first mapping I have created, where I have created analytical function and apply filter condition. So this is exactly equivalent to this mapping which I have developed previously and got failed. Use X. So in the previous mapping, whichever got failed when I have a serial number and then put the filter directly, okay. So this is the source and the serial number filter. So this this mapping is equivalent to this mapping because here in reusable mapping, I kept a source and then I put an analytical function. I have taken that and putting a filter. So in place of this, there is a serial number function I have written in this and taking that filter. So when I run it, it will combine both and then it will run. So it is nothing but this mapping only. Now if I run this, it is going to fail again. You can see source and it is taking. Okay, you have a expression component where I'm writing a derivation and then it is going to filter and then it's going to target. since it is equivalent to the same assembly, it is going to fail. Okay, but this is a reusability. Now, what you learn from here is a reusability means you can develop any logic outside and then that you can put in another mapping. Call in another mapping is called reusability. In that mapping, you can keep input signature where you can pass input to the reusable mapping from the mapping, or you can place the sources directly, okay, and that will be starting point in your second mapping. Okay, so right now it should fail here because it is nothing but we are writing a same function here. Okay, this is so far the topic which we discussed is reusability. This is how you can use it. But now what is the second, the benefit also you can achieve from the reusability, reusable map. So now this is our mapping and this is your reusable mapping I have placed here and I am taking and then using here. So if you click these properties, okay, we will start finding couple of other properties here. So when you click this component, mostly for all the components, you will find an option called subselect enabled. Okay. So whenever you choose subselect, so what is this? This is the reusable mapping. What is there in this reusable mapping? What is the logic we have? We have selected columns. We have written some analytical function. So that is nothing but this. That is equivalent to, we have selected columns. So there is an analytical function, but there is no filter condition. Okay, this is your actual logic which is there in the reusable mapping. Now, whenever you want to use this logic as a subselect to the second level of the logic, okay, so what you can choose, this is the table, this is the code which we have. So this code, after that whatever I apply, so that I want to apply in SQL how I showed you, subselect, inline view, okay. So in any case you can choose, for whichever table you want, you can choose subselect enabled. So whenever you choose subselect enabled, rather than directly applying this filter on the other logics, it will, so far whatever is there, this entire logic will be in one SQL and then you will get one more bracket. On top of that, the remaining logics will be applied. Okay, that is the subselect. Not only here, in any place, not only for analytical functions, if you have any complex logic, there is a big join and this I want to keep as a subselect and join with other table, in many places you can use it. But this is one of the best example to learn. Okay, and then if you go to, this is your reusable mapping signature, okay, this is a connection port and this is a subselect enabled, okay, because for this component it is there, and the filter. These are all common. And this is your target. And I am choosing control append fine. And remaining nothing will be there. This is already true. Okay, done. So now I am going to run this. So now this is successful. And if I go and see my target table, so you will find only 14. So for every employee, there will be only one record here. So what, how it could have been generated if you see the logic at this time. Insert into this table fine and select, you see, this is the select statement where the row number analytical function is there. And it is not applying filter where condition directly here. Since I have this is logic in reusable mapping. This I placed in another mapping. There I've chosen subselect. So the complete reusable mapping code is this. Then rest all whatever you applied has been applied outside here. Now you can see where S number, okay, output signature, that reusable mapping dot serial number equal to 1. So now it is working. So this is one best use case of the reusable mapping. You can use reusable mapping. The first one is developer benefit, but this is a technical benefit. Okay, this is helping you achieve some functionality in terms of technically. Okay, so this way you can take your sources or you can take inputs, you can take the logic and then you can make them as a subselect, okay, so that anything from next time onwards when you pick up, okay, it will be a part of a inline query and then the next will be automatically generated, okay. So that's why this is very, and whenever you are talking about analytical functions, so mostly you have to leverage reusable functions. In the older versions, we used to use with LO interfaces, but right now this will be your, not only this, let's say you have written analytical functions and on that column you want to apply some derivation, is a calculation, or you want to write one more derivation on top of analytical functions, this has to be selected this way.